So you want to create static trainers slash sheets for 32-bit games? Then I have good news for you. I wrote this library just for you, swed.dll. Let me show you some examples you can do with swed.dll. ESP slash wallhack, aimbot, teleport, unlimited money, unlimited health, unlimited everything. A whole world of trainers are waiting for you. Just watch this video to get started. So what is swed.dll? Swed.dll is a class library for C# that utilizes read and write process memory. It allows us to easily read pointers and read or write the values beneath. Okay, how do we get this class library? Well, you head down to the description and click on the GitHub link. Here, clone the project and open with WinRAR. Now open the project solution file and check that it fits your framework and runs in 32-bit. When you're done with that, hit Ctrl+B to build. Now that we have built the DLL, check in the bin folder of the project and swed.dll should be there. Let's test it on the game Assault Cube. It's free to download and will be in the description. We create a new application that matches the target framework. Now I add swed.dll to the references. I got mine on the desktop. After that, we will create a variable for the class and get the target process. Let's open Sheet Onion and take a look at the process. Now we choose something to read and write to. The ammo of the current weapon will be perfect. When we have found a working address, we'll pointer scan for it. We need something static to work with. Now choose a pointer you like. I will choose the one that has the main module. If you chose one with .exe, then write the same as me. Otherwise, if you chose an alternative module, then write that module name. Since the pointer has an offset, we will only have to read the module base and the base address. After that, we only have to add the offset when reading and writing. Now read our ammo. The readBytes method returns a byte array with the size we give. Integers as well as floats have the size of 4 bytes, so read 4 bytes and then convert them into an integer with bit converter. Let's see what our program spits out. Five. If we take a look in game, we will see the current ammo is 5 as well. Now let's give us unlimited ammo. We use the writeBytes method and also use the same address and offset as earlier. Since it takes bytes, we use bit converter again. And there you have it. Reading and writing using swed.dll. If you're having problems, then check out the other example trainers I will post in the near future. The memory class is also open source, so make sure to check it out as well and modify it to your liking. I'll see you guys in a different video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, send me a fax, I don't know, do what you want. I'll see you guys.